Hey, you guys, Chikara here. So I want to share my top 15 expert tips to becoming an Instagram influencer. This is the influencer playbook for you. So by the time you are done with this video, you will be a boss on Instagram and will be able to monetize your influence on there. Now, what makes me an expert? I have grown plenty of clients' accounts through my digital marketing agency, Karizma Marketing, and have grown them by 10,000, 20,000 and more followers and their Facebook communities by over 80,000 followers. I help support my clients, support 30 million customers and more through strategic marketing strategies. And I am my own e-commerce store owner back in 2007. So I've been in the space for a while, you guys. I know how this game goes. So let's make you an expert too, okay? And I have a free gift for you. If you want to learn more about that, make sure to stay tuned. I'm going to tell you actually in the first tip about it. If you'd like more support for your e-commerce business, you can check out our ad agency at charismamarketing.com, and you can check out my digital course and my 90-day e-commerce accelerator at takaracharisma.com. Okay, let's dive in. I want to get this done in under 10 minutes. So tip number one to becoming an Instagram influencer is you need to develop content pillars. This means 5 to 10 themes to build your posts around. So the cool thing is, linked below, I have a free content pillar, promotion calendar, and template for you to work off of, and ideas that you can use for your content pillars. These are things like behind the scenes, personal posts, inspirational posts, promotions, live events, product features, reviews, testimonials. But what you want to do is think about 5 to 10 different themes that sum up your business as a whole and plan out that content and those pillars throughout the month so that you're touching on all of these unique points of your business so your content is well-rounded. Now, tip number two is add value. Post helpful, scroll-stopping content that adds value and helps people. Don't just post about yourself with 4 words, right? Like, that's not going to tell a story, and we want to tell a story. We want to educate. We want to provide tips. We want to motivate. We want to train. We want to inspire. If you are a model and you're trying to gain influence in that way, then your strategy may be slightly different. But if we're truly using our social arm to add value, to show that we're an expert in our space, to build brand affinity, loyalty, and value, we have to tell that story through user-generated content, through trainings, through videos, and so much more. So make sure every post you do adds value. Number three, I want you to think about building your community by creating and engaging in conversations, right? So I've seen this mistake so many times where brands will post and they get all these comments back and they don't respond. I'm like, how can you do that? Like, someone took a moment to sit and respond to you on your scroll, on your feed. If you go to Takara Charisma on Instagram and you comment, I promise I will engage back. I will comment back because I want to have a conversation with you, right? So make sure that you are liking and responding to profiles who are engaging with you, that you're sending private DMs when appropriate, welcoming them to your page. Maybe tell them one thing you like about their Instagram feed. Actually look at it and tell them and invite them if they have any questions or if they need anything to reach out to you. This works for e-commerce brands, this works for influencers, and so much more. Okay, number four, go live. This helps you talk directly with your followers in an intimate setting that helps them get to know you. It helps them feel like they're connected with you and gives them one-on-one intimate access to you in an intimate setting that feels very personalized, where they can actually even hop on and join you. So you definitely want to incorporate going live when you can. And if you can do that around a schedule, that's even better. So tip number five to the Instagram influencer playbook, my top 15 tips to becoming an Instagram influencer, is commit to a posting schedule around your content pillars. Post content regularly. You can post in your feeds, in your stories. There's reels now. It's early 2021 when I'm making this. So there's obviously reels, there's IGTV, there's obviously other social media platforms, but you need to be committing to posting regularly. So whatever that looks like, whatever you can do, it's not about quantity, it's always about quality. Number six, write a scroll stopping bio that gets people to follow you. So use a link in your bio that helps people access everything about you. So I love tools like smart.bio. I like Linktree. I like linkedin.bio. I saw someone do it, and I think it's really cool. I may actually do this, where you put your website. So it's like your website.com/Instagram. And that is a landing page built very specifically for mobile that looks a lot like these smart.bio and Linktree tools, but it's on your own website. You're getting them to Pixel. There's no delay to going from this smart.bio tool to your website. And you can build it out in the same way those other tools are built out. So actually, I may do that in the future. I really like that idea. So imagine your website.com/Instagram. That's the link that you use in your bio. And you build that page out to however you want it to look on mobile. And that's where you take people and you tell them where your Facebook community is, where your digital courses, where they can book you for a motivational speech or to model, for example. You give them links to past posts, your affiliate links, and so much more. I really, really like that strategy. Okay, tip number 7 to becoming an Instagram influencer with success. Ask your community and followers to take the next step with you. So many times we invest so much into our content and we produce really great content, but we forget to ask them to take that next step, whether it's joining your email list by offering a download that adds value to them, follow you on YouTube, read your latest blog, building up your followers on other platforms, as well as your email list, is always going to help you expand your influence outside of just Instagram, right? And ultimately will give you a larger audience to sell with your brand partnerships or with your own products or services. So the larger your audience is, the more leverage you have when you go to the negotiating table, right? Or the more leverage you have when you are thinking of investing in your own products and services. So you definitely want to build out those communities. And remember, you don't own your subscribers on YouTube. You don't own your Facebook group followers, right? And members. So the only thing you really own is really your website traffic and your email list. So work on growing that email list. You can see my example in this video where I said, hey, I have a free content calendar and content pillar planner and layout for you. You can download it. But in exchange, we are going to offer you lots of value when we get that email, and we'll give you other tips and strategies to help you grow your business. But that's a fair exchange. We're giving value upfront, and in return, we're getting an email, right? So that's an example of that. Number 8, check your insights and analytics regularly. You need to know what content is resonating with your audience and what isn't, so you can keep producing more engaging content that works. Again, it's super simple on Instagram to check this. It's very simple, these kinds of analytics, but start to note what's working and what's not, and make sure what's working is in alignment with ultimately what you want to sell, right? And where you want your sphere of influence to be. So for example, if you are a woman like me and you want to be selling ad agency services and digital marketing courses and 90-day accelerator programs, it's probably not going to behoove me and help me to be posting bikini photos, right, all the time. It's not going to attract the right customer base for me. That's not what I'm looking to build. I'm not looking to be a swimsuit model. I'm looking to grow my ad agency. So I need to be producing content around that. I need to see what content works really well with that ideal customer avatar, and I need to do more of it, okay? Now, tip number 9, we're getting through these. Invite other larger brands and influencers onto your Instagram to expand your network, to grow your following from their following, and offer value to your followers. Networking with larger profiles gives you instant credibility in whatever you're doing. So a perfect example is I had Brooke Volinovich on my Instagram Live about a year ago. She had a much bigger following than I did, and instantly I picked up followers from that. She was actually in my space. She does social media management and teaches people how to grow Instagram. I do paid social ads. So it was a perfect woman supporting woman. My followers were perfect for her. Her followers were perfect for me. She was another female business owner, and I was able to really leverage that opportunity to interview her, to get in front of her followers, and also to expand my followers into her and to get to know her. So definitely leverage those opportunities and reach out to other brands and other influencers to partner up. Okay. Number 10, define your niche and audience and plan content around them. So plan ahead to what types of brand partnerships, products, or services you want to monetize through your Instagram account, and make sure all content you are posting attracts and speaks to the right followers that you may want to sell to later. This goes back to, again, that comment about I could post a lot of photos in my bikini and maybe I'd get followers, maybe not. I am a mom and close to 40, but the point is those probably are not the same followers who are ultimately interested in the service and products I'm selling. So everything I do is very strategic and comes back to, is this going to speak to the kind of follower I want to attract? So make sure you ask yourself that question and really define your niche and audience and speak to them through your content. Number 11, do hashtag research and use relevant hashtags in your post comments. Also, follow very niche hashtags that you can engage with regularly by liking their posts, leaving thoughtful comments on their profiles, and finally, engage immediately after posting with the most recent posts that were also using the same hashtags as you, because they're very likely to still be on Instagram and still active and engaged. And if you can immediately find people who are posting in the last 10 minutes on that same hashtag that you were posting on, you may be able to pick up a couple followers and start a really great conversation with them. Now, I always like to liken this. We can use 30 hashtags on Instagram, and I see that people don't always use them, and there's all sorts of conversations around hashtag strategy, what works, what doesn't. But ultimately I say, hey, if someone gave you $30 million, would you take all 30 million or would you only take 3 million? And of course everyone would take 30 million. So I say, it's free, use all the hashtags, use them in your comments. We'll see how effective the strategy is moving forward. It seems to work in very niche hashtags. It can work quite well, but it's up to you what you want to do. Just make sure they're relevant to what you are posting. All right, I should actually tell you my hashtag breakdown real quick. I like to, with those 30 hashtags, this is kind of my tiering system and how I like to break to with those 30 hashtags, 10 hashtags that have under 100,000 posts on them. I like to do another 10 hashtags or so between 100 and 250,000 posts on that hashtag. And then my final 10 are kind of like 250,000 to a million. You do not need to use this equation. It's just something that I like to use to make sure I'm using small, medium, and large hashtags and expanding my reach in that way. All right, number 12, tag other brands and businesses in your post, but only when appropriate, right? So if you're a makeup influencer and you're using MAC makeup and you're doing an eyeshadow tutorial, for example, you may want to tag at MAC Cosmetics in your post, like when you're actually posting, right? And get them to see your post. That would be very helpful because they will want to use, some brands who use a lot of user-generated content, UGC, would love to be able to use your content when you post them. And then that gets you in front of their millions of followers. It's a really good symbiotic relationship. The other thing I would do, which is taking a little research, taking it one step further, but if you are a true fan of certain brands and you're using their products, you may notice certain hashtags that they tell you to post with so that you can be featured on their feeds. So I would definitely take notice of that. If MAC Cosmetics with over 24 million followers says, you know, hashtag MAC love, you know, to be featured on our feed, I definitely would make sure I'd be using that hashtag and tagging them and using any hashtags related to their products or palettes, right? Because that, again, is going to leverage you to getting in front of their millions of followers. And if your content is good enough, they could very well share it, right? Number 13, tag your location in posts so that you can network with your local community. So especially if you are brick and mortar influence and you want to be known locally, you definitely want to be tagging your community and location in your stories, in your feeds, because that does help expand the reach of your posts. And I would definitely recommend that. So even if you're somewhere else, for example, when traveling, I might go to exactly where I am, or let's say you're at a convention, I would tag that very specific convention center right there. So other people posting from that convention center and in that area can see that you're part of that convention if you're trying to expand your reach during that time. I've used that strategy. I've used very specific event-based hashtags that no one would know unless they're going to the event, and picked up lots of followers that way as well. So it is a good strategy. All right, number 14. I love this one. Never buy followers. Bots will absolutely destroy your engagement. They're going to hurt any future ad campaigns that you want to run, and that will be targeting your followers, and it just looks bad. If you have 10,000 followers and you have no comments on a post, that screams something's fishy here, right? If you have 10,000 followers and you have 10 likes on your post or less, something's up, and it just doesn't look good, you guys. If you want to be a true influencer, grow your true influence and be smart about it. Try to hack it as best you can, but don't buy bots. It will, I promise, it will come back to bite you. It will come back to bite you every single time. Get real, true, engaging followers who love what you're talking about, who resonate with you, who are on brand for you, who are interested in purchasing your products, who are in the right country for you to be understanding what you're posting. So the best way to do that, post good content. They'll come. Just post valuable content. People want valuable content. They want to be entertained. They'll come. If your content's good enough, they will start following, I promise. But of course, you can use these strategies to start hacking it. And number 15, our final tip to expanding your Instagram influence and kind of growing as an influencer and monetizing your influence on Instagram is invest in an Instagram marketing course. I personally actually don't have an Instagram, you know, organic social post, but there's plenty other leaders in our space that do. If you're interested in a paid ads course, of course we have Social Savvy. That's on my website, karizma.com/social-savvy. It'll get your leg up on paid Facebook and Instagram ads. Definitely, if you want to be seen these days, it's worth spending some money on some ads and doing it well and knowing how to do it. But if you're interested in a course to grow, you know, organic Instagram followers, there's lots of great courses out there. Someone I love following is Jasmine Starr. I think she's really great about organic Instagram. So that's someone I kind of tune into. But there are many wonderful leaders in the space for organic growth. And of course, there's free tools like this, like YouTube and so much more. So I hope you enjoyed these tips. There is another video here for you to check out if you're interested in learning more about social media marketing. And you can always check me out at takarakarizma.com, the digital course, our 90-day accelerator program for e-commerce business owners, and the agency at charismamarketing.com. If you are about 6 to 7 figures in annual revenue, we may be a really good fit for your e-commerce business and running those ad campaigns for you, as well as Klaviyo email marketing, SEO, and Google Ads, and so much more. So I hope you found this helpful. Click below to get the content pillars and calendar for free to help you plan out your Instagram content. And I will look forward to talking to you soon. Make sure to subscribe if you want more free digital marketing tips. All right, bye.